going through. At the same time, I'm like, man, I'm not sure this will work. Like, what if this is going to be another thing that happens? I don't know if a lot of you, you've ever had those thoughts, you know, kind of come across your head where you're like, well, I don't know if it's going to work. I don't know if this is going to be my breakthrough. So I was fighting those two things. And I said, you know what, I'm going to put my head down and I'm going to go to work. I attended every training there was. And here's the mindset I had. Even though I'm attending the trainings and sometimes I will hear the same information over and over, I said, I don't know when the day is going to be the day that I needed to hear that one thing from that one person that can drastically change my business. So just doing that over the course of several months got me to executive vice president, where we're now doing over $500,000 every single 30 days in sales. So what I'm going to break to you is the power of the protection plan. And once I break down the power of the protection plan, I'm going to teach you some hacks, because I'm sure a lot of you saw a deadly battle. And I say deadly battle because I mean deadly battle, right? Between me and our partner, Miss Zakia, right? It was a very, very deadly battle going on, and she won the battle. And I give that to her. But I want to really also go over to cover some of the little hacks that I've been doing to get a lot of customers over these last couple of days. So let me first share my screen, as we always do it, to kind of go over the power of this protection plan and to kind of give you guys some of the inside scoop. So let me go ahead and share my computer screen here real quick. Perfect. Are you guys able to see this? Okay, great. All right. Good. All right. Let's log into the demo account, right? I have so many passwords here. All right. There we go. All right. So let's close out of these tabs here. Close out of this here. Boom. Perfect. So guys, with the protection plan, the number one important thing, the number one thing that is most important is that you kind of go in here and you activate everything. So if you're brand new, let's just say you're a couple of days in, you haven't even activated the services or to even know how to get there. Here's how you actually get there. First off, right? You want to actually go to your member account, which if the person that signed you up sent you the website to actually enroll, well, if you're an agent, it's not going to be the same website. But the website that you actually use is UCESProtectionPlan.com, and you got to put www in front of it. So www.UCESProtectionPlan.com. And if you're an agent, you always want to put slash your username, so that way it brings up your website. And you want to go ahead and you log in. And once you log in, that's when it's going to go ahead and bring you to this page where I am right now. And how you log in, you use your email and the last four of your social. And once you're in here, guys, it's not just credit repair that we do, right? So when I first got started, I'm like, okay, well, credit repair, fancy, woo, woo, woo. But it's so much more that actually comes with our protection plan once you actually start to, you know, get to know your product and start to really learn this stuff, right? So for example, we have something called the debt payoff, which is an amazing, amazing, amazing thing that the company has put in place. So that way, you know what's going on, like your debt, you actually align everything together. So you know how to actually attack things better. And we also have, especially for the ones with the family, right? Will and trust. The will and trust is something that is extremely, extremely, extremely important, guys. And I say that because prior to FES, I was doing another company where all we were selling was legal products, will and trust. And we literally put a lot of emphasis on it because we watch families build wealth. We watch families like build a crazy legacy that couldn't get passed down, all because they did not have a will. So you got kids, you got family, you're building a future. you want to get your will and trust done because that comes with the protection plan for you guys. And guess what? You can educate yourself on the products. Just click on them, watch the little videos. It details, it tells you like in specifics, right? What everything is about, what you have to do, so on and so forth. And those of you that are agents, it's not showing here because I'm on the customer demo account. You have the life insurance, right? That you can actually activate. How the life insurance works, you know, the more that you're active on the protection plan, obviously the better it is for you. So your first couple of months, you don't get the whole 100,000 released to you. So as you're actively building your business, I believe after your first 12 months, it actually opens up, but it requires a certain amount of volume, so on and so forth. But you want to read up on those things and you want to activate it right away, because what happens if, let's say, you've been building this business for 2 years and we don't want this to happen, but God forbid just something happens. Now, the whole lifestyle that you done built for your family has to go ahead and change because you didn't set yourself up for it. Like, you got this thing that's here, you don't pay not a dollar extra for it. It's you. All you got to do is activate it, submit who you would want to benefit in any case something happens to you. As you're building your business, any interruption happens, now your family can be catered to because you done built something and you done set the proper things in place so they don't have to worry about it. Guys, I am telling you right now, you want to take advantage of your product. And it's because I did my due diligence, right? I did my research on the back office. I went through every single thing here. When some of the skeptic customers on social media questioned me, well, what else do I get for credit repair? You're telling me I got to stay on this service for 3 to 7 months. What else is going to do for me? Now I can tell them, look, we got will and trust. We got this. We got that. We got this. We got that. We got credit my rent. And like, oh, okay, this makes sense. I thought you just wanted to take my money every single month because it didn't make sense. What if my credit gets fixed in 2 months? Now what am I going to do? And I'm able to really provide a better picture. And the more educated that you are on your product, the more and more customers that you will forever attract in this business. So you want to make sure you go through your portal, the budgeting, the credit restoration, so on and so forth. And also, guys, I'm glad I'm on this, on the credit restoration tab. What I have realized, a lot of you, especially when you first start to get a lot of customers, you know, you're just telling the people to activate the stuff, but you're not really following up with the clients to make sure they're receiving their dispute letters, to make sure they're sending them out. I know one thing about business. You can build a huge book of business, get a whole bunch of customers to come in, but if you're not providing good service to make sure that your customers are taken care of, you're not going to be in business for a very long time. So please make sure you're following up with your customers. Like today, I done checked on like, what, 30 of my customers. Hey, look, I'm just checking on you. Did you get your dispute letters out? Is your score going up? Is everything okay? And people appreciate that. People appreciate that. So you want to make sure that you're going through the process, making sure they not only set their stuff up, but they're getting those letters, right? And they're getting them out to the bureaus. They're signing them and they're actually getting some quality results, right? So that's what I wanted to actually mention. Now, before I actually bring on, you know, the mother of our organization, right? Because to be real with you, the training spotlight today is not for me. I can't even afford the spotlight that's about to be put out today because had it not been for the person that's getting ready to come up next, none of us would probably not have the opportunity, you know, to actually be here. So before I bring her on, I wanted to actually highlight, hey, give me a few minutes. I'm actually in the middle of a training. I'll call you right back. All right. Man, call me like 7 times. Sometimes you have those clients. But yes, so I wanted to actually, you know, just highlight real quick, what have I been doing for the past few days? How have I been getting those customers, right, to sign up? How have I been getting these people to complete the enrollment? Like, what have I been doing, right? And I know a lot of you, you've been wondering. You're like, yo, how is this guy able to keep up with Zakiya? Zakiya dropped one 1 minute, he drops one 30 seconds later. She drops another one, he drops another one. So how I've been able to actually do it, guys, and to be real, I haven't shared this with a lot of people, but my Instagram ad account, right? Instagram and Facebook, because it's the same thing. My ad account has been blocked for almost 3 months now. So I haven't been able to run any ads. I haven't been able to pique anybody's interest and have Instagram promoted for me. So I've been struggling on getting new leads. I'm telling you guys right now, it hasn't been the easiest. So what I did do, instead of sitting back and saying, man, where am I going to get customers? Where am I going to get people to get my product? I'm like, I'm in business. If I can't get, you know, customers, I'm not going to be in business for long. So what I did, guys, all the people that I was talking to in the very beginning, I literally just went back to them, right? And I found the first list that I've ever made when I joined FES. You know how they tell you, hey, make a list of 20 people, make a list of 30 people. Some make it, some don't. When I first joined FES, I made a list of 100 people that I wanted to become agents. And then I made another list of 100 people I wanted to become clients. So I got access to that list and I went back to every single one of them. Some of the responses I got was, man, I've been meaning to reach out to you, man. I see you've been doing your thing on social media. I see you've been helping people, man. I've been trying to tell you, I've been trying to fix my credit. And I didn't even open my mouth to say, do you want to fix your credit? So this is why we tell a lot of you, don't quit before your blow up comes, because some of these people, they're just watching you. It's like some of us, we want to come in this business and we want to have one magic post that just draws every single customer to you. Otherwise, you're quitting. And here's what I learned from a very successful mentor of mine in this business. He said this. He said, Kerlens, if you got, for example, Bank of America, you go and you ask Bank of America for a loan of $100,000. Whether you got good credit, decent credit, it doesn't matter. $100,000 is what you ask for Bank of America, but you don't have $100,000 in your checking account. What is that called? And I said, that's called having good credit. He said, no, that's called stealing. That's not having good credit. You don't got the money in your bank account, but you want Bank of America to provide it for you because you think you got good credit. And I couldn't understand it. And he said, Kerlens, this is what people do. You don't have it available, but you want somebody to provide it to you. And this is what we do when it comes to our social media. We come out of nowhere, we put a credit post, we want to get 100 customers. And you haven't added anything to your people that's watching you as far as free knowledge, as far as free value, as far as why they should follow you, as far as who you are, but you want to get an instant withdrawal out of them where they got to swipe and give you a payment. And that's what I learned to be patient with over the past few months, over the past few years I've been in the industry. All I've been doing is giving people who I am, giving people my story, giving people my journey, giving people what I want to do. And in return, a few of them have trusted me over the years that they've watched me. Now I can ask them to purchase a service, right? I can ask them to become a client. I can ask them to let me fix their credit or whatever it is that I decide to do. And that's what you have to be okay with. Keeping up with Zakiya wasn't the easiest thing, but because I've been adding so much value to my followers, so much value to the people that I've talked to in the beginning, all I had to do was go back through my list, go back and do a few follow-ups, and bam, I was able to actually get those customers back to back to back to back to back. And that's what I want to bring to you. It's good to make the post on social media, but make the post at the same time. Don't get discouraged if they don't respond to you right away. They're still watching you. They're still watching to see what you're about to do, what you're getting ready to do. And with that, you're going to be able to close a lot more deals. I do realize it's a lot easier said than done. I'll tell you guys exactly how I went about it. On my follow-ups, especially for the few people that I've already talked to in the beginning, the phone call was very simple at that point. All I did was, yo, how's it going, man? You know, wanted to catch up with you. I know we spoke back in April, but I wanted to let you know, man, you know, I've helped a lot of people fix their credit over the last few months. I don't know if you've been watching my Instagram, but I wanted to help you, man. I just helped this client, man. Her credit was 432 within what, like 5 or so months of using our service. We got her from 432, her credit jumped to 750. And then the response I'll get out of them, man, I'm in the 500s right now, man. I'm trying to get a house. Look, man, I know when we spoke, I told you I was going to take care of you. I told you I was going to give you a deal. I'm usually charging people $800-$900, but you're my friend. You're a cool dude. I respect you. Look, I'm going to get you in for $188, $89 a month. We'll get everything going. Plus, I'll get my team on it right now, and we'll see if we can get your disputes out tomorrow. And that is how I've been getting a lot of the people to sign up with urgency. And another thing that I have been doing, guys, is I've been using the referral source. And let's say I sign up 3 customers. My goal is to turn the 3 customers into 9 or 10. And how I've been doing it is once I sign them up, they submit the application. They call me back. I walk them through the setup process. I tell them, hey, have you ever had someone tell you they can fix your credit for free? No, that don't exist. I said, look, we got a great referral program. I believe you know a few people that might also want to fix their credit. I'm going to fix yours for free. All you got to do is you refer me first 5 people. I'll make sure you don't have to pay for the service. What? Man, this lady, she opened up, like, she worked at a call center. Man, she went around telling every single person, cubicle to cubicle. My phone was ringing off the hook for days just because this lady said, I can fix these people's credit because she wanted to get her account for free. Like, she was literally working for me, not even as an agent, as a client, because I got them excited. So those were some of the major key tips that I wanted to kind of lay out for you guys. And I wanted to make sure that you got, so that way you can actually enhance and actually grow your business. So if you guys learned something, especially on the customer aspect today, do me a favor, drop a 10X in the chat for me. If you learned something on how you can now take your business on the customer side of things to the next level, drop a 10X in the chat for me. Perfect, 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 perfect. Now, guys, do me a big favor. Here's what I want you to do. Here's what I've been actually seeing and what I've been realizing. A lot of us, we'd attend the trainings. Here's what I don't want you to do. I don't want you to be a professional meeting goer. I don't want you to be a professional training attender. I want you to take some of this information that we're giving to you, literally, and I want you to start really applying it. Could you imagine you literally pick up the phone and do exactly what I told you I did for a few of these people that I've been able to get in the system? Could you imagine what level of success you would have? So after this training today, I want you to give yourself a target. How many customers you want to sign up for the week? If that's 3 customers, if that's 5 customers, 6 customers, 7 customers, man, 7 customers could put an extra $700 in your pocket for the week. I want you to make that goal, draw out your list on how you're going to achieve it, and go out there and make it happen. Like, honestly, I don't want to be the person that comes to you every single week, give you a training or that little thing that you were looking to hear. And then boom, you just shut your computer down. You shut your phone off and you go right back to the thing that you were doing. I want to be the person that comes with enough motivation to get you off your butt and get you to go out there and do something about your situation. Go and crush the charts. Go and let people see who you are. Go and become that top performer within your business, within your organization, within your circle, so that way you can take your business to the very next level. So with that being said, I want to take everything back to Tano, so that way he can make sure that he introduces our very next guest speaker. So with that, I love you all. Thank you. And thank you for your leadership.
Man, oh man, oh man, guys. That was absolutely amazing. If you got value from that, ladies and gentlemen, go ahead and drop some fires in the chat. If you're on your computer, don't worry, I got you to drop a number 5 in the chat. If you're on your computer, Mr. Kerlens Casseus just absolutely dropped the hammer, you know, with everything just now, man. He was on fire, right? He was on fire. Man, he was on fire. He was on fire. Yeah. But listen, I'm not going to take up any more time because we already, it's a 6:06 right now. And I know you're boiling. I know everybody is waiting. They're like, man, I want to hear what, you know, this boss lady is going to say. I want to hear everything that she's going to deliver this evening for us. So I want you to continue to drop those fires. Continue to drop those fires. Let me go ahead and kick back this fire, right? I want y'all to see it one more time before I bring her on. Top producing vice president, the mother of our organization. Guys, man, so much wealth of knowledge that's going to be delivered this evening. I hope you change to another page. Go sharpen the pencils. If you don't have a pencil or a pen, you know, borrow one. Or if you don't have a pen or a pencil, you know, bite your fingers, get the blood, and get ready to start taking some crazy notes, guys. So without further ado, we already know what time it is. We already know what time it is in the building. So what I want to do right now, I want us to put your hands together as we welcome the boss lady herself, right, of the organization, Miss Vice President of our organization, coming through, Miss Tiffany Renee. Come on, guys, drop some fires in the chat. Let's go. Woo! Drop them fires. They don't want no more. Man, they don't want no more. Welcome to the call, boss lady. We can see you. We can hear you. Let me go ahead and make you host, and you can take it away. Go ahead and take it away, boss lady.
Man, oh man, oh man, what's going on, Mogul Nation? How are y'all doing tonight? I just want to say, man, Tano, you give Billy Scott a run for his money. I'm just saying, they might have to put you on the Millionaire Mindset calls on Monday. I mean, because
I
didn't know you were a DJ too,
don't,
man. And you a great host. I just got to give it back to you.
Don't do that.
We're going to let Billy Scott know if he ever want to call out sick, he got a replacement for today.
Nah, we got Joe. Joe got that all out.
Nah, man, I just got to say thank you so much, Tano, for your leadership, top producing regional sales director. Always grateful for you, brother. Love having you on the calls. I mean, we do some powerful wealth talk conversations at 7 p.m. sometimes, and I'm just so thankful for you. And I got to give it back to our executive vice president, Mr. Kerlens Casseus. I mean, what a blessing it's been to have you as a top leader on my team. I mean, to see the culture that you've created, to see the movement that you've created, to have one of the largest, rapidly growing organizations in the whole company. I mean, in less than a year, I just got to say kudos to you and your leadership, guys. So, hello, everyone. My name is Tiffany Renee. Like they said, I'm vice president. Let me just get myself together here. I'm going to share my screen with all of you so I can get this presentation going. One second, guys. Oops. So, guys, just to give you a little background about myself, I got started with FES back in July. I've been with FES July of 2018. So I'm approaching my third year this year. It's amazing how fast time flies. Prior to getting started with this, guys, you know, I went to college, I did the whole school thing. I graduated from college. I was working in sales as a recruiter, actually, for a technology company in Philadelphia. They transferred me to South Florida, guys, and guess what happened? 6 months after they transferred me, I was laid off, guys. I was laid off right when we came back from our holiday break. It was Christmas and then New Year's. And that week that we came back, actually, the day we came back, I actually found out that I lost my job. And I was devastated. I was like, man, I uplifted my whole life and for this company and they let me go. And that was actually one of the biggest blessings I ever had. I was jumping around job to job just trying to figure it out. And so I got into bartending and waitressing because the jobs were not paying me enough for me to pay my bills, guys. And so I got into bartending and waitressing, and as a bartender waitress, I got into real estate. And so I was like, you know what? I'm going to be like those millionaire realtors that they show on HGTV. And guess what? It wasn't like that. And it wasn't like that because a lot of people just didn't qualify for home ownership. And so I lost a deal, guys. My client had a 750 credit score, pre-approved for a $2 million loan. That's a $60,000 bonus, a commission, guys. So he got approved, and guess what? Through his divorce, his credit dropped 300 points. He was at a 450 at the end of his divorce. And guess what, guys? I lost a $60,000 commission. I was devastated. It was right around Christmas time that I lost this. And I said, man, you know, what am I going to do? And so a young lady at my job, she actually was a bartender as well. She introduced me to FES as a realtor. She said, listen, I have a way for you to actually close more deals to help more clients get qualified and a way for you to make some money in between deals. And I thought about it and I said, man, if I'm having this challenge, I know that a lot of other realtors are having this challenge. So guys, what I'm going to talk to you about is a very niche focus. You know, we get a lot of training about customer acquisition. We get a lot of general training about recruiting agents. But oftentimes, a lot of people know that I'm in real estate. I've been in real estate for 4 years now, and they always come to me, what do I say to realtors? How do I go after realtors? And so my focus today, guys, we're going to talk about how to target realtors. We're going to talk about how to get free leads, because I know a lot of you, you know, you invested into this and maybe you don't have the budget to go out and buy ads. Like Kerlens said, sometimes your accounts get frozen and then what do you do? So I'm going to show you, you know, some tips about getting free leads. And then I'm going to talk to you guys about finding other professionals through a professional social network called LinkedIn. So hopefully you guys have a pen and paper, because I have a lot of information. I'll try to condense it as much as possible, but this is definitely a topic that I love to train on. So let's talk about real estate professionals, right? Realtors need more qualified leads. Realtors have very, very fancy titles, guys, but guess what? A lot of them are not selling enough homes. A lot of them are not getting enough renters to get a rental property. But guess what, guys? We have the solution. So when you would have someone that wants to buy a house, guess what, guys? There's three important questions a realtor has before they can even move forward with that client. They ask, how's your credit? They ask, what is your debt to income ratio? They also ask, do you have enough money saved for down payments, inspections, appraisals, closing costs? And guess what, guys? Oftentimes, most clients do not qualify in one of these areas or all three of these areas. And guess what happens to that realtor? They don't get paid. They're broke until their next, they're unemployed until their next closing. And sometimes it takes months and months and months and months for these realtors to actually have closings. And a lot of realtors, they're not six-figure earners. But guess what, guys? We have the solution. So listen, when you're talking to realtors, you got to break the numbers down. And don't worry, I'm going to show you how to talk to realtors, but this is so important, guys. You have to know the numbers to talk their talk for it to make sense. Because a lot of realtors, they aspire to be six-figure realtors. They don't even know that they have the capacity to be a seven-figure earning realtor. So let's talk about it. Most transactions, realtors get 3-6% commissions on their transactions. So you ask these following questions to realtors. What is your average sale in your market? And you write that number down. How many homes do you sell on a monthly basis? You write that number down. And then ask them, how many clients do they turn away due to lack of qualifications? Remember, I just went over. These are the three qualifiers. So you can go into details. You know, do they not qualify because of their credit? Do they not qualify because of their debt to income ratio? Or do they not qualify because they don't have enough money saved to go to closing? You'd be amazed at how many people get to the closing table and the deal falls through because they don't have $1,000 set aside or $2,000 set aside in addition to make the deal happen. And so you write these numbers down, and I'm going to show you what to do with these numbers. So you blow their mind away. So remember the first question I said is, what is the average sale in your market? You want to ask them that, right? And so for example, say they say the average sale is $300,000. Okay, that's a nice sale. The average commission on that is about 3%. Most realtors get 3% on a deal. So what you want to do is you want to do this calculation. So you take the average sale that they have in their market and multiply that with the average commission that they earn. So in this example, an average commission on a $300,000 sale is about $9,000. Do you see why realtors are so cocky? Because they're like, oh, if I just sell this one house, then I'm going to make $9,000. And in their mind, they're like, if I could just make $9,000, life's good. You know, if I could do this every month, that's over 100K a month, right? But guess what they're missing, guys? Look at the next question I said. How many clients do you turn away due to lack of qualifications? So say, for example, they turn away 10 clients, guys. Do you realize that's $90,000 on the table? And so when a realtor tells me that they only work with those that qualify, I bring these numbers to them. I said, so I guess you're too good to make an extra $90,000 a month. Because what could happen for you is if you had access to that, guess what could happen? Over a year, you are now earning seven figures. Are you too good to earn seven figures? And I get their minds thinking. Guys, we have the solution as Kerlens went over the protection plan. What do we have, guys? We actually have credit restoration. We have a debt accelerator program where they can actually pay down their debts on their terms. We also have a savings goal. A client can actually go into the portal and set up the money they need for a down payment, the money they need for inspections and appraisals and closing costs. And guess what that realtor can do? That realtor can ask that client for their login credentials to make sure that they're following the system to control their process. And what does that do for the realtor? It extends their pipeline. So you might say, well, how do I find realtors? They're very accessible. And I'm going to show you guys some tricks, some tips after this. You can find them on Instagram, guys. Go in the search bar. Just look up hashtag realtors. There's so many realtors that'll come up. Look up boss realtors. Look up black realtors. I mean, just look up words that have realtors in it. And guess what? You're going to find thousands upon thousands upon thousands of pages that show realtors. And guess what happened? When you go on a realtor's page, that's their real estate page, you can see who's selling houses and who's not. And you, because realtors are very proud, they'll show when they got an offer under contract, they show when they close, you know, they celebrate their success. And what you'll find is that most realtors are not closing on a monthly basis. They're not closing every 2 months. They're not closing 3 months. Some realtors might even close only one deal in a year. And so that will give you insight to talk to them about their business so that you can offer value to help them extend their pipeline. You can also go through Facebook search, guys. There's so many realtors on Facebook. And within Facebook, there's so many realtor groups. And I'm going to show you some examples of what I've done within Facebook groups. And then definitely, guys, there's so many on LinkedIn. And this is not just limited to realtors, right? You got to think about other industries that utilize credit, that depend on credit for them to get paid. I'm talking car salesmen. I'm talking mortgage brokers. I'm talking those that sell solar panels. These numbers are the same. If you're dealing with someone that's a car salesman, you ask them, what's the average car sale for you? What's the commission on that? It might be, you know, $200 to $500. Well, how many cars are you selling a week versus how many people walk into your dealership but get denied because of their credit? Guess what? If you could just help that many people close the deal, you have more money in your pockets, right? And so you guys got to get creative and think about those industries that you can help people within the industry that they're in. So let's keep going. You might say, okay, I find a realtor on Facebook or Instagram, whatever. What do I say? This is an example of a conversation that I've had. I said, hello, congrats to you on your realtor journey. I want to offer a way for you to grow your pipeline and make additional money in between deals if you're open to it. She said, hello, is it credit repair? I said, it's a financial services company that includes credit restoration, budgeting, debt payoff, and savings. Why did I highlight those four specific services? Because those are the services that clients need in order for them to qualify for home ownership. So don't approach this as like, it's just credit repair. We're not just credit repair. We are financial services. We offer financial solutions. She said, oh, okay, awesome. I said, would this interest you? It's been very helpful with getting more clients qualified to buy? She said, sure, I've heard of similar agencies, but I want to know more about yours. And guess what, guys? Another way that I approached them, because there was a conversation within a group chat where there were realtors saying that they wanted to go full time, but they couldn't. So I said, hey there, my name is Tiffany Renee. I'm a realtor and business development coach in the finance industry. Again, not in credit repair. I have a work from home opportunity available and looking to connect with more individuals interested or involved within the real estate industry. I'm hosting a live Zoom tonight at 7 p.m. Come mm-hmm. check it out. Let's get more income your way. And guess what, guys? She said, thank you. I'm definitely interested. And guess what? She came to my webinar at 7 p.m. So when you talk about what it is that we offer, guys, have that posture. You know, don't just say I'm a credit agent. You're not, because all of you are leaders on here. All of you are building businesses. So guess what? It's okay to call yourself a business development coach. That makes you sound very, very, very important. And you got to dig into these groups to find out who is looking to grow their business, who needs what we have, and guess what? We have the solution. And a lot of you, you guys get very stuck on scripting people. When you're dealing with professionals in sales, salespeople know sales pitches. They know when they're being scripted. You do not want to script a salesman. They're gonna cancel you out very fast. So people always say to me, what script do you use to get realtors to sign up? It's not a script. I have an introduction because I just want them to at least be open to me adding them to my network. And then I get them on the phone or I get them into a presentation so that they can see the full scope of everything. And that's what I did. I brought her to the presentation where she could see exactly what it is that we offer. And so what if they say no? That's fine. Because we don't care if they want to say no, they don't care enough about their business. Trust me when I tell you, if they don't want to help their clients, they don't want to help their clients get approved, they don't want to have more buyers, guess what? They're not serious about their real estate license, and a lot of realtors are not. That's fine. So you trial run them. Say, listen, I just want to add more value to you because I said that I help realtors grow their pipeline. I help realtors get access to qualified buyers. So try this out. I want to help you find more leads in your network. Simply share this post and see who wants to buy a home, but is not quite ready. You'll be surprised. And you give them the post to share. Now, what you do with this post, guys, when they share it, you got to follow them because they're probably going to have tons of people that say, me, 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 me. And guess what, guys? Forget the realtor at that point. Go after the people that said me, because what can we do? We can talk to them about becoming a customer of the services. So we are getting free leads and they don't even realize the game that we're playing. So it's okay if they say no. They can say yes, they can say no, we still win, right? And so, like I said before, who else has this dilemma? I said car salesmen, people that sell solar panels, people actually finance solar panels. So you have to have good credit to do that. Mortgage brokers, property managers, loan originators. And don't forget, guys, we also have rent reporting. That is something that is so critical, especially since they've added the second credit reporting bureau, Equifax. Because now what happens is when someone wants to purchase a home, lenders look for that middle number. They don't take an average of the three. They take that middle number. So imagine a client adding that rent reporting to their profile, and that middle number happens to be with rent reporting. Guess what? That client has a higher chance of getting approved. And then beyond that, ladies and gentlemen, when you're talking to realtors, right, you got to explain to them, imagine how many other realtors you know in your office struggle with this. How many of your realtors are actually closing? Okay. And so guess what? What if you could position yourself to be like your broker, right? So your broker makes commission on all of your sales. What if you actually made additional income because the realtors in your network are helping other realtors get qualified buyers? You've opened yourself up to have more income. And then beyond that, ladies and gentlemen, I don't know if you know this, but realtors are not allowed to pay out commissions to Joe Smo. So say, for example, Tano says, hey, I have a friend that wants to buy a house, but I want some of your commission. By law, I cannot give him a commission because he doesn't have a license. But one of the things that I ask realtors, I ask them, how many states are you licensed in? Most of them are only licensed in one. What if you could actually make commission by helping clients buy houses nationwide without having to get licensed in those states? They're gonna say, how do you do that? Well, you can actually refer deals out as a agent. So a realtor can refer a deal out to another realtor. So if I have a customer that's in Texas, but I'm licensed here in Florida, guess what? When that customer is ready to buy a house, I can call a realtor in Texas and say, hey, listen, I have a client for you, but I want a 25% of your commission. And they agree to it. It's common. So now they have opened up multiple channels for them to earn income within their real estate business, as well as making money in between deals by helping their clients get qualified, as well as extending their pipeline of leads for those clients that will eventually be ready to buy. Does that make sense? So I'm going to shift gears out of this. I'm going to talk to you guys about LinkedIn in a second, but I just want to see the chat to make sure if that was helpful, guys. Drop a 10X in the chat if you feel like that will help you take your business to the next level. Hopefully I didn't go too fast. All right, guys, I'm going to come out of this screen and we're going to share a different screen with all of you. One second. Here we go. Somebody's mic is not muted. Let me see who is on here that is moving around. Shannon Ingram, please stay muted. Thank you. All right, guys. So I'll go to that second. So one of the groups, guys, that I found, you guys can join this group if you'd like, is called Black Girls in Real Estate, but there's so many other real estate groups. And I just want to show you guys an example, guys. You want to get involved with groups. You should be joining industry specific groups, because people that are in groups engage within those groups, and that opens up a channel for you to have access to leads. So within this real estate group, the admin posted who wants to become a full-time entrepreneur but is nervous. And guess what? There was over 250 responses. You know what I do at night, guys? From 10 to about midnight, I go through engagement posts like this, and that is where I find leads to approach people to help them get started with our business. So you definitely want to get involved with groups. So I want to talk to you guys about LinkedIn. If you're not on LinkedIn, you definitely want to be on LinkedIn, because LinkedIn gives you access to a lot of professional individuals. It's not like Instagram. It's not like Facebook. This is a different ballgame. What LinkedIn is a professional public resume. And people utilize LinkedIn to build a network of professional individuals so that they could either move up in their company, find another opportunity, or so forth. And so what you guys should be doing is you all should be on LinkedIn. I want to explain something to you. Your LinkedIn page is your public resume, okay? And so when you set up your LinkedIn, guys, you want, and I'll show you why I'm doing all of this. When you set up your LinkedIn, guys, you want to have a banner. So I made this banner on Canva. You guys can download the Canva app. There's a lot of fun things that you can do on there, but you want your banner to stand out. When people come to your page, you want them to see your mission, what it is that you're about, right? You also want to make sure that you upload a very, very professional picture. No duck faces, no kissy faces, no athletic wear, professional, because these people on LinkedIn are polished. You also want to set up a mission statement. And so my mission statement is on a mission to help more individuals to become more financially literate and achieve the financial freedom that they dream of. That sounds really impressive, right? It's like, man, what is she all about? And you also want to put in your collegiate experiences or whatever current position you have. Now, what I've also done with LinkedIn is that I put, there's a tab here as a business that I can put, I'm hiring. No, I'm not hiring, but I'm recruiting. They don't have a recruiting button. So I put that I'm hiring. So anyone that even sees that purple glimpse, they know, oh, she might have an opportunity for me. And I'm going to show you why in a second. And then guys, as you go down, you want to make an about section about yourself. Make it very engaging, guys. You know, make a story about it. Don't be boring. Don't say, oh, my name is Tiffany and I graduated college and da, da, da. Like, no, you want to tell a story about you, and then you want to invite people to your world. So the last line says, if you want to join our journey and help as many people live their best lives, I want to talk to you today so that you can own your tomorrow. It ties into my banner, own your tomorrow. It's a common theme on my page. And then guys, you also want to add in your professional experience. And so it's okay to show your progression in a company. And guess what happens? Every time you get promoted, you can actually add that promotion and it alerts your entire network. So people can congratulate you. They can inquire more about your business. And you want to show this all the way down to the first job you've ever had. So now that you have your page set up nice and professional, I'm just going to show you something. So say I want to find more realtors. So I come in here and I type realtor. So what you can do is it's going to pull up all of the realtors. Now, this is not filtered yet. Look at this. over 1 million realtors show up. And guess what, guys? Maybe I want to build in my backyard. So we're going to narrow this down to Fort Lauderdale. Guess what's going to happen? It's going to show me all of the realtors in Fort Lauderdale. And what you want to do is you want to send a connection request. Now on LinkedIn, you have to send a connection request before you can have some, before you can be included in someone's network. Okay. So that is your opportunity to pitch them slightly to, for them to determine, hey, I'll connect with you. Because the way that LinkedIn works is that who you're connected to sees your information in their network, in their network, in their network. And so I've been flooding this thing out, but I'll show you one of them. This is not a realtor. So say, for example, she just recently connected with me. I said, hey, I came across your profile, super impressed with your history in real estate over the years. I'm looking to add more skilled individuals such as yourself to my network. Let's connect. I just want connections, because once I have these connections, guess what? Everything that I post about, you can post videos, you can post regular standard posts. They all get notified and their networks get notified, especially when they engage with those posts. And so it's just that simple. Now, another trick that I want to show you guys with finding leads beyond just realtors. I mean, look at this real quick. You guys are going to be like, wow, one second. So I'm going to type in seeking opportunities. Let's look at people. Guys, there are 948,000 people on LinkedIn looking for a job. Could you imagine? So when you're sitting there and you're like, I don't know where to find leads. I don't know where the people are. I don't know who needs more income. Guess what, guys? They're here. There's 948,000 of them. And then you can go ahead and you can, you know, select which territory, you can select which company. And guess what, guys? Another hack that I want to share with all of you. Start Googling companies that went bankrupt last year. A lot of people lost their job. Over 700,000 Americans lost their jobs last year, and there's more coming in this year. So go on Google and type companies that filed for bankruptcy. And what you can do is you can come on places like LinkedIn, find employees that have worked there and offer them our opportunity. So with that being said, guys, that's my training. I think I ended right on time. Yeah, we're at 6:30. I just want to thank all of you. I hope you found value, and I'm going to throw it back to Tano.
Wow, wow, wow. Man, guys, drop some fires again in the chat. If you got not only value, but you already see the opportunity where you're like, oh, I'm going to apply that. Oh, I'm going to apply that. Oh man, I'm going to definitely apply that, right? To be able to take your business to the next level. Drop some fires in the chat one more time for the boss lady, Miss Tiffany Renee, for coming on here and just absolutely shutting it down. And I mean, she did that in like, what, 15 minutes? like, where do they do that at, right? But drop some fires, throw some high fives. This is just the beginning, guys. We told you this year we're lining things up, because I'm telling you, things are going to get crazy. We want everyone to be prepared. We want everyone to be shooting for the stars. And whatever your goals are, if you take these nuggets that Miss Tiffany Renee has, you know, shared with us, right? You take these nuggets that Kerlens Casseus has shared with us, and you make it your utmost duty to go ahead and apply, whether it's 2, 3, 4, 5 of these things, whether it's from the back office, whether it's, you know, I want to connect with more, you know, car salesmen. I want to connect with more realtors. I want to connect with more people in that seeking opportunities in general, right? I want to make these different connections so that I can continue to add to my pipeline. And I'm telling you guys, by this time next year, your business will be completely different. Mark my word. So with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to get up out of here. But I just wanted to, you know, jump on here and just thank, you know, my crew for rocking with me today. I want to thank each and every one of you. Drop a high five for yourself. There's 84 of us on this training this evening. 84 of us has been blessed with this information. And what you do with it is up to you. You know, the leaders have poured their hearts out this evening. So it's up to you now what you're going to do with the information to take your business, your families, everything to the next level. Because I'm telling you guys, 2020 is year. If you made a commitment, you're coming for 2020. It's time for us all to show up. So with that being said, take care. I love you all. God bless. Remember, this evening at 8 p.m., I will be live along with Mr. Mark Lampier. Again, at 7 p.m. as well in the Haitian community. You want to get your guest on, you know, plug into these different Billy Scott 2.0. Fruit, stop it, okay? I'm not. You see what you done started, Tiffany, right? But listen, let's plug into the 7 o'clock training with our guests, guys, and I will see you all. And I'll be dropping some DJ hits at 8 o'clock along with the boss man, Mr. Mark Lampier. Guys, take care. God bless. Mogul Nation for life. Let's go.